Born in Baltimore in 1951, Edward Witten grew up surrounded by science, his father a physicist and his brother a screenwriter. But Edward, he started with something else entirely, bridging the complexities of mathematics and the mysteries of the universe, attempting to solve some of the unknowns shadowing our world. He began his academic journey at Brandeis University, graduating in 1971 with a major in history and a minor in linguistics. Next up was Princeton University. In 1973, he started in applied mathematics but switched to physics, earning his PhD in 1976, working under the legendary Professor David Gross. Soon after his PhD, Harvard snapped him up, starting as a postdoctoral fellow. After 1 year, he became a junior fellow with the Harvard Society of Fellows, giving him the chance to pursue advanced studies, free from formal or teaching requirements. In 1980, he was back at Princeton as a professor of physics. He received the MacArthur Genius Grant, providing substantial no-strings-attached funding to continue his research as he saw fit. And at Princeton's Institute for Advanced Study, he truly made his mark. His work in string theory wasn't just influential. It was revolutionary. In the 1980s, he realized string theory didn't just allow for gravity, it demanded it. He called that the greatest intellectual thrill of his life. In 1995, he unified five string theories into M-theory, becoming the first physicist to win the Fields Medal. He didn't just master string theory, but is also a leader in quantum field theory and topology. He introduced the world to Witten's index and, alongside Nathan Seiberg, changed how we understand four-dimensional spaces. Witten has published over 330 works, mentored future giants, and received nearly every major science prize you can name. Yet he remains humble, a quiet force, shaping the very foundations of physics and mathematics. Edward Witten, the mathematician who taught the universe a new language and continues to astonish the world, constantly pushing knowledge to its absolute limits. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, stay calculating, my friends.